In this video, you're going to learn how to set up your product feed for Google Shopping with the Google Shopping app for your Shopify store. This allows us to quickly set up our product feed so we can start running our Google Shopping campaigns and make sales and profits for our store. We've used this method to generate a lot of sales for our stores, like this one, and this one. Now, what is required to set up your feed with this method today? The first thing you need is to set up your Google Merchant Center account. This means going to merchants.google.com, setting up your account and adding in all your settings and business information. You then need to claim and verify your website, add your shipping information and your returns and refund information. This process is quite straightforward and I have videos on every single thing you need to do here. I'll leave a link to those videos down below. I walk you through the process step by step. These videos are actually all part of our free Google Shopping course that shows you how to set up, optimize, and scale your campaigns. I'll leave a link down below. Go and check that out and then keep going through this video right here. Once complete, your Google Merchant Center account is ready for us to go and we're going to open up our Shopify dashboard and make sure we're logged in. You can also access this Shopify app by going to apps, customize your store, searching for Google Shopping Shopify. Then go below this video and find the link to the Google Shopping Channel app. You should see this page. Make sure you only use this app here called Google Channel by Shopify. We use this app because it's free and easy to use, and I want to save you guys the pain and money. You need to make sure you're logged into Shopify before we can install it. So make sure at the top it says log out to know that you're logged in. Just click the button that says add app. It's then going to show you this confirmation page. Scroll down and click add sales channel. Now you should see this page here. Just click connect Google account. It's going to ask you to log in. Click allow. Great, it's now connected. We then want to go through this checklist section here and make sure to check these off. This means having the valid payment method on your store, making sure your store is public, adding a refunds returns policy and terms of service, and making sure you add your contact information onto your store as well. I'm going to confirm that I've added contact information to my store. Click confirm. It's then going to ask me to verify my contact number. It's then going to confirm my product feed settings. If you're not sure about this, just go through the free Google Shopping course and go through the website compliance video. I'll leave a link to that exact lesson below. It teaches everything you need to make sure you're compliant. If you don't make sure you're compliant, as soon as you try running your ads, your account might get banned, and then it's even harder to fix. So I recommend getting this right the first time to save yourself a world of pain later. Next, we want to accept the terms and conditions and click complete setup. Next, we'll see this page here. We'll now make sure that our feed is set up. Click manage availability. It's then going to show us all the products in our store and we will now optimize our feed so that we can get more clicks and more sales. This is an important step. Don't skip it. Optimizing our feed means editing each product field in this table. Now for some of these fields, this is actually editing what's on your website, but I'm also going to show you how to edit the titles and descriptions so it shows up differently in your Google Shopping campaigns. Optimizing the fields like this is a key part of scaling your campaigns, generating more sales and more profits. We'll go through all the edits we need to make right now to optimize our feed here. First, we need to unhide the columns that we're going to be editing. Make sure at the top here we have the following columns unhidden: title, available to Google, Google product category, MPN, page title, and meta description. Once you see these columns, we're now going to go through one by one and make sure the product information is correct as well as optimize it. First, we're going to start with the product title. Your title is the most important product field for Google. Your Google Shopping campaigns will perform much better if you spend the time to craft and optimize title. These titles here in the title column are actually what's on our e-commerce store, but honestly, you don't always want to have the same title in your shopping ads as what's on your store. Look at this example. This brand is selling a backpack called Lita, but how would Google know what the heck a Lita is? A better title would be Sling Backpack in Gray 40L. See how that's much more descriptive and also optimized towards what a customer might search? The question I often get asked here is there some sort of formula for a good product title? The answer is yes. We have a full guide on optimizing your titles using formula structures. It also includes these templates of the structures that you can use for your own titles, and I'm going to leave a link below this video. Now, something to note is that this title here means that you will be editing your website title, which is probably not what you want. That's why we unhid this column, page title. This means that instead of editing the title on the actual page, we're editing what's called the SEO title. This means what Google is going to show in the search results for organic listings, as well as affect what's going to show in your shopping ads. Now, let's edit our first title here. Snooze Go is not a very descriptive title for what we're actually selling here, which is a white noise machine. So I'm going to change the title to something a bit more relevant. I've put here white noise machine with fan Bluetooth enabled. This is just an example, but you can imagine that people are going to be searching for a white noise machine with Bluetooth, maybe with a fan, and this is going to better target those search queries. This is going to allow Google to better understand what we're selling here to show to the right customers and get us more clicks for less. Now that we've optimized our title, we can now optimize our description. Similar to the title, Google does give the description weight in how to show your products to the customers. What I like to do here is just pull in the actual description on our page and then edit it to make sure we clean it up for any HTML or anything like that. Think about what sort of description someone that's searching for your type of products is going to want to see in the search results before clicking on your page. Keep in mind that you don't have a lot of space here, so keep it as descriptive as possible while sticking to the main points. Now that we've done that, let's adjust our Google product category. This column is for us to put in the Google product category for each product. Google has their own big list of categories that help them figure out what your product is. We need to check this list for the most relevant category for our product and then paste in the code into this cell for each of our products. To find this list of all the Google product categories, check below this video. I'll leave a link to it there. Search through until you find whatever is best related to your product. For example, we're selling white noise machines, so I just searched for white noise and it's pulled up 4056 as the Google product category. This may take a little bit of searching, trying out some different sort of keywords until you find what is most relevant. You do want to spend the time to get this right because it's going to really help Google find out what you're selling and show it to the right people. I'm going to copy our Google product category number. I'm going to go back and paste it into that cell. Next, we have the MPN. This is the manufacturer part number and is assigned by the manufacturer and is unique to every product. This is so that someone searching for a Toyota air filter can search for a specific MPN that's tied to their specific make and model. It is a good idea to provide this MPN. Maybe you'd ask this. What if your product doesn't have an MPN? Well, if you don't have a GTIN, it's mandatory to have a brand and MPN for your products. You can't make up a GTIN if it doesn't exist, but you can make up an NPN. Just make sure it's unique to every product in your feed. If you have to, just add in the SKU in the NPN field. If you don't have a GTIN, this is an optional field. Though I do recommend adding it if you know it or you can find it for your product. Otherwise, leave it blank. I'm going to add in the SKU for my products here as the NPN. The next thing I want to show you is editing other fields for your Google Shopping products here in Shopify. You can click the link here underneath the product status, and it's going to show you this page here with your products. Now here you can actually click edit Google fields, and it's going to show you this window here, which allows you to directly edit the MPN as well. You can scroll down and change the Google product category here. It also provides a link to all the Google product categories too. Here you can edit other fields that are important depending on your product category. For example, if you're selling apparel, you do need to put in the age, the gender, the color, material, and sizing details. So keep this in mind depending on your product category. You also have custom labels here, which is for future use. Don't worry about that now. We'll cover that in a future video. Once you've made the required changes, you can then go back to the Google channel and wait until your product status goes to approved for all the products. It usually takes 3 to 5 business days to get these approved. Once it's done, you'll be able to confirm that your feed has been set up by going to Google Merchant Center, go to products and then feeds, and then confirm that your feed is now listed here. Once it's set up, you'll often see these sort of product disapprovals, warnings, or errors in your Google Merchant Center account under this tab, Products Diagnostics. That's normal for your first time. We're going to spend some time fixing these up. If you don't fix these up, your ads just won't show. It's as simple as that.
How do we fix errors and disapprovals? This is the process of reading the error, finding out what caused it, and then fixing it. Now, this is a tedious process and it takes a little bit of time and we're not able to cover it in this video, but I've created a full video guide on how we fix our errors and disapprovals. I'll leave a link to that right below. After fixing our disapprovals, we're then ready to create our Google Shopping campaign in our account. As you can imagine, I also have a full guide on doing that too. I'll leave a link to that below, but if you haven't noticed, we teach everything you need to know about setting up and optimizing your Google Shopping campaigns in our free course. I recommend you go through that course sequentially, doing everything required and then growing those campaigns to make sales for your store. I'll leave a link down below, but if this video was helpful, guys, please give it a like, let me know in the comments below, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye for now.